One thing I wanted to mention about Argentina, I don't know if you know about this. Have you been to Argentina?
I've never been to Argentina.
Okay. So one thing that you'll quickly notice, especially if you go to Argentina as a study abroad student, is how they celebrate graduation. And this is like a really, really interesting thing that I haven't seen in other countries, but also haven't like lived long enough in other countries to see this. But your final day of university, right? Your final class, which is usually like your final exam, right?
Okay.
You get up that day and you dress in clothes that you don't mind getting ruined, okay? Everyone usually, like, you know, they get up, they dress in clothes that they're like totally fine with. They go to school, they take the exam, and they know that when they're done and they walk outside, their entire family and probably friends are going to completely cover them in eggs, in flour, in vinegar, in oil, you name it, paint, all the things, oatmeal, whatever. And for like, you know, however long, till all the supplies runs out, you just stand there in a corner while all your like closest friends and family just douse you. It's ridiculous. It's so ridiculous.
Why and though?
I don't know. I think it's just like one of those kinds of random traditions that happened. You know what? I should look up the history on this, but I'm assuming that it was like one of those random traditions that happened. They're like, Facu se gradua, se va a graduar hoy. Vamos a agarrar cosas, tirando todo. Right? And it's funny, like, around graduation time, you know, around like December and around like, probably around like June, July. You'll just be walking down the street and you'll see like random spots where it's just like filled with eggs and flour and all these things on the ground. You're like, oh, someone graduated today, and so, you know, that's one thing that's like super unique.
That is so interesting. It's so cool. Like, I love, you can just see your passion, like, and you can hear it. It's so cool.
Learning Spanish completely like changed my life.
Yeah.
Like, it defines who I am. It defines like the majority of my like the strongest connections that I have today amongst friends and you know, colleagues. It's the best decision I ever made.
Yeah.
Like hands down.
Yeah.
Hands down.
I agree. I honestly feel the same way.
Argentines, porteños, actually, you're not going to find this so much across the rest of the country.
Mm.
You know, as an American or a gringo, you know, the idea of greeting someone with a kiss on the cheek is just not what we do. That's not how we were brought up.
Right.
And even doing it with a girl, like in the beginning, I was a little shy. It was kind of like, do I go for it?
Yeah.
You know, like I feel like I'm invading her space, you know, until like I eventually started hanging out with enough Latinos in the States that I eventually would just go for it.
You know?
And then there would be these moments where I would go for it with an American girl and she'd be like, sometimes they would be accepting to it as well. You know, you never know. The guys in Buenos Aires greet each other with a kiss on the cheek, right? They just like, you know, it's the classic, touch your cheek to their cheek and kiss the air, right? And that was something for me that I was like, you know what, man, I just don't feel comfortable with this. Mm. This is just weird, like, you know, I'm not into this. And my friends were like, man, whatever, like, you're gonna do it one day, you know? Like, you're gonna do it. And so, funny story, there was one time, it was the first time we got invited to a family asado. And in Argentina, asados are like, well, you know, asados in general, you can find this in across all cultures, but the barbecue, the asado is like super importante. And it's buenísimo ir a un asado en la casa de un local. Right? So I was so pumped. It was like a group of like seven of us that were in Argentina visiting. This wasn't when I was living there yet. And I was just like, yes, like we were like buying like Malbec, bottles of wine, which also I can talk about that later. Malbec is from Argentina, from Mendoza, Argentina. Yes. It's buenísimo. Me encanta. So we get to the house, you know, knock door, they open up. Friends there, and we're like going through and like greeting the sister, you know, and we're like greeting the mom, and like I'm last in line, right, as we're coming through, and I'm like, oh my god, like there's the my friend's dad is standing there, and like, I gotta, like, how am I gonna tell this man? He invited me to his house, El Asado Argentino. How am I gonna, like, negate him of his beso? Cheat, you know? Like, he's standing there, and he's like, that thing. Yeah, God, you know? And I'm like, no me queda otra. Like, I don't have any other choice. I gotta go for it, you know? My friends are, like, standing on the side, and they're like, like, we know it, you know. And you know, after that day, I was just like, you know, this is so stupid, you know. This is like a form of affection, and right. Like, yeah. Saying hello, it's just like a hug, you know. And this is what Porteños do, this is what Argentinos do. And you know, if I really truly love this culture, like, right. I really need to incorporate that, especially when it comes to human connection.
Definitely.
Yeah. And I went for it, and you know, now I don't even think about it.
Sure.
You know, you greet anyone in Argentina, and that's how you do it, with the beso.
Definitely.
Guy or girl, and it's just, I like it, kind of. Like, I would even say, like, I'm even a little bit more affectionate after having lived in Argentina and
experienced
culture. Like,
yeah.
And I think that's so important, you know. Show love, you know.
Right. Amen. Just,
so another thing in Argentina that you can expect that I love, when it just comes to kind of like, you know, fiesta culture, like just when it comes to them partying, they go all out. They really know, Latinos in general,
yeah,
and Argentinos as well, you know, and you know, in general, like, they listen to like cumbia, and they listen to cuarteto, and this is, you're gonna find this in all, like, almost all the parties in Argentina, and it's something that's important for you to kind of learn if you really and truly want to interact with Argentinos. You need to kind of, like, really, first of all, not be afraid to express yourself through dance. Again, this is a Latino thing in general, but like, you know, no one is afraid to express himself through dance, and that's what I love. They just, like, truly feel the music and then interpret that and express that. And I think it's like another way to connect with people is through dance. And definitely. So a big, like, proponent of that, and advocate of dance. So cumbia and cuarteto are for sure the two dances that, you know, you're gonna see and you wanna absolutely learn. Cumbia, they're both fast paced. Cuarteto is a lot faster paced. I actually did a video of, like, teaching my mom cuarteto. that's something that I think that anyone who's gonna, like, get involved with la cultura argentina should for sure pay attention to and be aware and you know, learn it to connect better. That's the goal at the end of the day. So
definitely
another thing that I really like about Argentine culture, which this is something that is simple to learn and like will give you all the points. And it's involved with asado culture that I was talking about before. El asado argentino es increíble. They, like, all parts of the cow, you know, it's like a ritual. It's like a ritual starting the fire, you know. Everyone's kind of standing around, maybe drinking some beer or maybe drinking some Malbec, some wine. You'll have, like, you know, the previas, you'll probably eat some empanadas. I love, love, love provoleta. Have you ever heard of that? Provoleta is like this, like, thick piece of provolone cheese that has, like, herbs and, like, oils and herbs on it, on both sides. And maybe, like, a little bit of, like, harina on it. And they just throw it on the grill, right? So it's, like, crocante on, like,
and then,
like, it's really crunchy on the outside and then gooey on the inside. And they'll, like, serve that up before, like, you eat. It's kind of like another one of the appetizers.
Oh, cool.
Dude, it's so good. This is, like, when any of my friends are in Argentina and I'm there with them, I take them to una parrilla, which a parrilla is an Argentine, like, barbecue restaurant, if you will.
Okay.
You know? It's like, but it eats steak, and a steakhouse. And we'll absolutely first get, like, vino, Malbec. I love, actually, blends, like Malbec with Cabernet. And then order empanadas. I like the empanadas fritas, cantan. And then I'll get some provoleta. And when, like, you just try a piece of that provoleta and you drink some Malbec, it's just like, it makes me think of, like, that Will Ferrell, like, so good, but it hit your lips. it's so delicious. Anyway, when you're at a an asado at someone's house and you've eaten, like the whole process is gone, which usually takes hours, I'm always like there, just kind of waiting for this moment. Like it's like one thing that I do, because you get so many points for it, and it's positive, sure. And it's fun. And I think with learning a culture or learning a language, you want to show positivity and enthusiasm.
Sure.
And I think that really goes a long way. Even if you know very little, I think that's going to like go a really long way.
Definitely.
And anyway, you say, un aplauso para el asador. And so someone will yell it. Someone will be like, un aplauso para el asador. And everyone in unison is like, woo!
That's awesome.
It's so awesome, dude. Because it also like creates a unity as well. Everyone's sure. just like, at that point, people are kind of like, like semi borrachito, and like people are full and people are happy, and it's just like, you know, it gives him his moment. He like bows. Yeah. It's so fun, man.
That's so cool.
So, un aplauso para el asador is definitely one of those tips, awesome. Or those tips, those hacks.
Yeah.
And I know any Argentino that's watching this right now, cualquier Argentino se está cagando de risa.
What?
I wanted to see if you could guess.
So these are all representing groserías. La puta mierda que. I don't know what this one would be.
Alright, la puta madre que te reparió y la concha de tu hermana hijo de mil puta.
Oh god. Oh god.
Oh my god, dude. The first time I saw that, I couldn't breathe. I was just crying. I was like, obvio que un argentino inventó esto. Again, most of this is porteños, and they created this mala fama, right? Because like most of the time you're gonna hear like, es un argentino. No, un argentino. No. Right? Like you're gonna get that all the time, and I think the best way to handle it is just kind of like. Hay que meterse en su juego, right? Like, just know, like, you ever heard the phrase, like, know your audience,
mm-hmm.
right?
Yeah.
Like, Argentinos are amazing. Porteños are incredible. If you just kind of know how to, like, interact with them, you know? Like, yeah. they mean well. They don't mean any harm. Estamos hablando.
Okay, estamos hablando. Good to talk to you, man. Bye.
You too.